Hello and welcome to the Tricourse for January 29th. Today we're talking about superheroes. It's me and Louis today. Louis's not here at the moment. He's going to be here very shortly. Ellie is away with flu, so it's just going to be the guy course today. I believe Louis's bringing in a special guest. Yeah. To start off our theme with superheroes, we're going to go in with Mr. A. Goodbye, Mr. A, by the Hoosiers. Enjoy. That was goodbye, Miss.
The Hoosiers.
The Hoosiers. Louis is here.
Hello.
And we have a special guest as well. Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Here's Tom. and we're here to talk about superheroes.
Superheroes.
Let's start with all the superhero movies that are coming out this year. We've got a list up here.
There's another X-Men film. Another one. It looks like another one where it's like set in the past, I think.
Have you seen the X-Men films? I have not seen any.
I've not seen any of the new ones. I've seen the old ones. They're good.
Don't they have like separate movies for the people, like Captain Fantastic, whatever it is, and the Hulk and Wolverine?
That's not X-Men.
No, there's Wolverine, Mr. Fantastic, or something. I don't know.
Mr. Fantastic is the Fantastic Four.
That's the same thing.
Is its own film.
Who is in the X-Men then?
There's like Wolverine.
Wolverine.
Xavier. Storm, I think.
The woman who's blue. And yeah.
There's that hedgehog man that goes all spiky.
The hedgehog man.
There's the Juggernaut. I'm the Juggernaut. That one.
Oh no, that's Fantastic Four again. The big rock man.
Yep. That's Fantastic Four.
Oh. I'm not very well qualified for
Fantastic Four. Juggernaut is X-Men though.
Is it? Yeah, Juggernaut is.
Yeah.
What's the one on the Fantastic Four called? I can't remember. Yeah. Oh, the Thing. Yeah.
The Thing. And Stretchy Man.
There's another Avengers film.
Is it a proper one that says this isn't like Confidential?
No, Confidential Black Widow and Punisher.
Okay.
It looks like a spin-off.
Yeah. I don't know.
Some kind of spin-off.
And...
I
think it's a film about Black Widow, which no one cares about. There's a film with Scarlett Johansson out. There you go.
Sure.
Yeah, people watch that. Why not?
Actually, no, it's not even Scarlett Johansson. It's Jennifer Carter.
It says I'm starting to doubt this list. It says that there's Silver Surfer.
Yeah, this list says there's a lot of films that aren't actually coming out.
It's Captain America, though.
Isn't there, what's it called? Ant-Man.
And
a new Robocop.
Oh, yeah, that is coming out.
Robocop, really? Oh, yeah.
A new Robocop's coming out. The trailers look... Oh. I want to say the word fantastic, but in a completely ironic way.
Oh, you know what? Oh, there's a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Oh.
Do they count as superheroes?
They probably do. Yeah, I'd say they do.
Low-level superheroes.
Kind of age superheroes, don't they? It's like, you know, watching the Amazing Spider-Man cartoon, like...
Yeah.
Superman, and then Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Did you guys watch The Amazing Spider-Man, the new one?
I haven't seen the new one.
The new one either.
The new one's really good. It's much better than the other one.
Amazing Spider-Man 2 and 3.
Amazing Spider-Man.
The Amazing Spider-Man.
Amazing Spider-Man 2 is not out yet.
Not yet. Is it coming out?
Oh.
Yeah, it should be.
Nice. Amazing Spider-Man 2 is.
Yeah, it's got a...
That dude in it from The Thing.
Yeah, The Thing with the... Yeah.
The Thing with the dude.
But no. Yeah. Watch the Amazing Spider-Man. It's really good. It's better than the one with... What's his name?
Tobey Maguire.
It's much better than those.
I can't pass judgment because I've only seen the Tobey Maguire ones.
Yeah.
Tobey Maguire ones are classic.
Watch it. Watch it tonight. I might watch it, actually.
Spider-Man 3 seemed a bit odd, though. It was always just Tobey Maguire crying all the time.
Pretty much.
Seemed to be it. Just the whole film. Just let him cry.
It's kind of a sadistic film.
Yeah.
Everyone's watching it like, yeah, cry, Toby.
Because there wasn't really an enemy. The enemy was himself in the black suit.
Yeah. But
then he fought the black suit at the end. Like, what?
He rang a bell.
Maybe it's a metaphor for...
The dark side in all of us.
For wearing black latex.
Wearing black latex, yeah.
Fight it. Don't do it. And then you'll just be crying at the end of the day.
Especially in New York.
Yeah,
aren't there weird clubs in New York that do pure, just latex, like, fantasies? I'm sure there are.
I don't know.
I'm sure I watched a documentary once about it, and it was really weird.
Oh, there's always weird documentaries like that. They're always by, like, Channel 5 as well.
Yeah, and there's always this, like, one dude where you're like, can people really be that creepy? So there's one dude who was like, I want to buy you some shoes, you wear them around New York for a week, and then me take them off you at the end.
It's nice.
And just oddly
like,
specific.
Use them? Yeah. A very strange fantasy.
Oh, there's a 300 sequel.
That's not really superhero. I thought 300 was the one with Sparta in.
It is.
Yeah.
Apparently
that's a
superhero movie.
Sort of is. It's big men killing little
Oh, and it's got a god in it. So.
Oh great.
Captain America film. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which is hilarious because.
They're gonna be live action.
They're not teenage, right? They're not mutants, and They're not turtles. They're aliens. What is the what is the point of it?
Aliens invade Earth.
They're alien reptile warriors.
So
okay,
right.
Adult alien.
Adult
ninja
alien
reptiles.
Yeah, basically.
That's just one
it's absolutely ridiculous. I can't remember who's direct. It was like a that one guy that always messed the film. I think he did like Transformers.
The one guy that always messed the film. I don't know many directors.
Yeah.
Apart from M. Night Shyamalan.
Another Transformers film. Yeah.
2015.
An actual new Avengers is out next year. Star Wars, arguably not superhero. Well, I guess in the world that they're in, they could kind of be superheroes.
Kind of are.
Maybe. I wouldn't say there were any superheroes. I'd say there were supervillains.
Wow. There's Ant-Man. That sounds interesting.
Who is playing Ant-Man, though?
Paul Rudd.
I like Paul Rudd. Paul Rudd's cool.
Paul Rudd?
He doesn't look very superhero-y, though.
Who's Paul Rudd?
He's a... he's in Anchorman.
Yeah.
Anchorman?
I know he is. He was in Friends.
He's in Anchorman. He was in Friends. He dated Phoebe. Him. Him. Anchorman. Imagine him with a...
He looks like a generic
Imagine him with a handlebar moustache.
Handlebar moustache. He just looks like a general man.
Ant-Man, starred by General Man.
Generic Man 1. Generic Man. It's like when you read when you look at credits and it's like, passerby number 1, passerby number 2.
Yeah.
Played by so-and-so. It's like, did they really need some kind of reference?
What, passerby number 1, played by passerby?
Yeah.
They probably did demand it.
Just putting all the credits as, all the extras as credits. Just to make the movie seem longer.
So yeah, I think that's it.
Yeah,
that's basically
it. Was an Anchorman.
Rumored, just to
rumored,
see. Hancock 2. That'd
Hancock
be cool.
Hancock 2, yeah.
Liked Hancock, kind of.
I didn't see Hancock, I keep meaning to.
Well, it was alright.
It wasn't Wanted 1, the one where they curved bullets and things with Angelina Jolie.
Yeah.
Oh, and Spider-Man. Yeah. Was Wanted with Spider-Man? No, it was it wasn't.
It was with someone else.
It was with Malcolm in the Middle, wasn't it?
No. It was,
I'm getting very confused with movies here.
There's too many things merging into one.
Shia LaBeouf? Wasn't he in Wanted?
I don't know.
No. It was a Scottish actor. It isn't like a film that was in 2013, which is called Filth, which no one saw. It was basically just about him doing loads of drugs.
I don't know.
It was very strange.
I hear that Filth is very good, though. Despite everyone not seeing it.
Yeah, no, I've never heard of it.
There were some adverts around, but like nobody saw it. But everyone who has seen it is like, it's really, really good. So I don't know.
Mm. Well, we might as well watch it then.
Yeah, we'll watch Filth.
Do you hear our next song?
That's going to be our rule now, is to watch Filth. Yeah, let's play our next song. It's one I purely picked for the title. And because I was looking at a list of delete songs from GTA 5.
Again?
Yes.
You're replacing Ellie with
this. No. Ellie plays songs that are on GTA 5. I play songs that aren't, but could have been.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's almost worse.
That's not actually true. This is the first one I found. But it's got the word Superman lovers in it. I mean, Superman lovers. They love Superman.
Can't
argue. Anyway, this is Starlight by Superman lovers. That was Starlight by Superman lovers. They love Superman.
Why?
Why not?
I didn't hear anything about Superman in that.
It's implied.
Their love is false.
It's hinted at.
Love is false. It should be just called the Superman
love. They love him, but like a friend.
Like a friend. Superman, you're pretty cool and all, saving the planet. You know, we love you. Yeah. But not in that way. Don't get out of my bedroom.
But Superman is all well and good. But what about Batman?
Batman's pretty good, though. Batman is pretty good.
Batman's alright.
Classic question of who would win in a fight, Batman or Superman?
Superman.
Well, yeah, I mean... I do wonder how that question is such a big thing. It's like Superman versus Batman or Superman. You know, Superman is like invincible, can use heat ray.
He could probably...
freeze breath.
He could probably pay... Bruce could probably pay Superman to, like, kill himself.
I doubt that.
How would that?
What was he going to do with that money? He's like,
yeah,
hey, have this money, so you can't spend
it. He could use it to buy his homeworld back, I don't know.
Buy his homeworld
back. Use it to stop being a little whiny girl. You know?
Oh my.
Here's some money. Treat yourself.
That's what I hate about Superman. He's always like saving people and everything, but he's always just like, I want to go home.
Yeah, quit whining. You've never even seen your home. You don't even know what it's like.
He was a little baby in a pod.
Didn't he go to his homeworld in that film last year?
I don't know. I didn't watch it. I watched the first remake they did.
It was like Zod or someone came down from Krypton.
Yeah, I watched that first remake that they did.
Didn't that flop? Wasn't that really bad?
Probably.
I remember there being a PS2 game for that.
Yeah, I played it and it was awful. It was the worst thing in the world.
Not as bad as Superman 64, though.
That's well known.
It's well known for being terrible. Not as bad as Aquaman 64, though.
That's a classic.
But the bigger question is, does Batman count as a superhero?
Batman, I'd say yes. I mean, I'd say he classed as a hero, at least.
Even with the new films, they just call him a vigilante.
Yeah.
Well,
he is. He's just a dude in, like, a suit of armour.
Yeah. He's
got money.
He's just a dude with money. That's it.
Yeah.
Instead of batarangs, he just has coins.
Yeah, that's the thing with Batman, though, is, like, everyone in there seems to be just a random dude who's, like, had some trouble in his life or something. Like, Two-Face just burn off part of his face.
Yeah.
That was his only, like, power quote.
Did you see Batman Forever? That's a good film.
If it wasn't one of the trilogy that came out soon.
Which one is it?
It's basically, in the comics, I believe Two-Face got a Two-Face because he got, like, acid spilt on him or something.
Yeah.
In Batman Forever, he just got a pot of hot coffee thrown across his face. It shows it. They took footage, and it's like Tommy Lee Jones playing Two-Face and Jim Carrey playing the Riddler.
I can just imagine, like, he's, like, got a slightly red face.
Slightly red face, yeah.
Look at that, it's hilarious.
And then it goes away after, like, a day.
It's really stylish, it's all, like, wavy.
And, like, Batman Begins with Harvey Dent? Where his face was, like, just gone.
The Dark Knight.
His face was just gone.
That scared me the first time I saw it. I saw it in the cinema and he just turned around and it kind of scared me.
But that's the best one because it's got Heath Ledger in it.
Yeah, that's... The thing about Batman, though, is there's a lot of things in there that he does really, like... It's very clever.
Yeah.
Apart from when he walks into an arena with Bane and locks the door behind him, that was a bit stupid.
That was really stupid.
Yeah.
That was very stupid.
Boom!
The Joker, though, he's insanely smart.
Yeah.
There was that whole thing about the scene where he's got a gun to his head and says to Harvey Dent, like, you can shoot me now if you want to. But he's actually, like, holding the trigger or something, or holding the chamber so that he can't actually shoot.
Yeah.
It's a big thing. The hammer or whatever it is. I don't know guns. I don't kill people. It's not a thing I do. It's not a thing I enjoy.
But no. I think he's my favourite.
See, I prefer Jim Carrey. Jim Carrey's the Riddler. Batman Forever's worth watching just to see Jim Carrey in a skin-tight lycra suit with question marks all over it.
Jim Carrey never really has, like, serious roles, does he? So I guess that would be one of the few where...
He had one or two, and one of them he played as an insane guy, and the other one he played as a gay guy.
Wasn't Jim Carrey in Kick-Ass 2?
Yeah, and no one knew who he was.
But he didn't enjoy the film, so he was like, no, I'm not in this. I wasn't really in it.
Yeah. Now, what was the reason behind that? It was like,
He knew.
No, it was... There was something to do with, like, violence in it, and he went through some...
Trauma,
yeah. I think it was when there was, like, a shooting or something. Or, like, the Boston bombing or something like that, and then he was like, yeah, I don't like this film anymore, because it kind of... comedicizes violence. Made violence seem like funny, and he didn't like it. So
I kind of wish I'd seen the movie now, just to see why Jim Carrey wasn't happy about it.
I just remember my friend showing me the trailer, and it was like, "Look, it's the trailer of Jim Carrey," and I was like, "Where's Jim Carrey?"
Yeah, it's 'cause he looked nothing like him.
Nothing like him.
He had a chin. He had an actual jaw.
He had that weird costume.
He's normally just all teeth, isn't he?
He was in The Mask as well, wasn't he?
Oh yeah,
that was pretty good.
Classic. Never want to watch it again, but no. Still, yeah.
One of those films you watch once and never see again, like Ice Age. Have you ever seen Ice Age more than once?
Of course I have. I've seen it a billion times.
Thanks to ITV.
Yeah, thanks to ITV.
That's about it. Yeah, just the repeats.
So we've learned that ITV's just reruns of really old films that you don't want to watch, but you watch anyway because there's nothing else on. And then Channel 5 is kind of documentaries about freaks.
There was a period in college about 3 years ago where it seemed that ITV 2, the only movie they would ever play is Shaun of the Dead every day.
Really?
Yeah, it was like started at 9 and finished it whenever it would finish, like 11:30 or whatever. It was just Shaun of the Dead every day, I swear.
But Shaun of the Dead is so good that
Shaun of the Dead
could watch
is
it every
good.
Day.
I could watch it every day. And I do. No, I don't.
I got a copy of Shaun of the Dead, but I can't open it. It's still got the tag on, so I can't open the case. I think I've got to break the case.
Hammer it. Just get a hammer and bash it in the middle, pull it open.
Yeah. Not a good idea.
Just sellotape the DVD together. Done.
I'll put it in the microwave for a little bit.
Put it in the microwave.
It'll eventually melt off.
Just try and cut open the seal. Let's move on to our next song. I don't know how this is superheroes. Would you class the Men in Black as superheroes?
They save the world.
Yeah, but they're not really superheroes.
Why?
Are they?
It depends whether you define a superhero by the fact that they have powers which are, like, above normal. Like, unique powers which aren't just human. Or whether you define them by the fact that they do, super deeds, you know.
Super deeds, yeah.
Super deeds!
I don't think I'd say that they were superheroes, though.
Because if the Men in Black aren't superheroes, technically Batman isn't a superhero either.
No, but I said Batman is a hero, at least.
Oh, they'd be
there
heroes.
There we go,
too.
Will Smith, you're a hero, you're a national treasure. We love you, Will Smith. Here's your song, Men in Black, just in case you're listening. Smith, you are good.
Will Smith.
Was that Will Smith? Hancock, I Am Legend.
I Am Legend. I watched a film with him and his...
His son.
His
oh,
son.
What was that? After Earth?
Yeah. I watched that the other day. That was all right.
The trailer looked all right.
Except for his son, I wanted him to
look. It seemed like an incredibly cliché plot, though.
Yeah, I kind of wanted his son to get mauled to death by an eagle.
That's
but
nice.
His son...
I think the whole point of that film was just father's son.
Yeah, basically. Will Smith was like, give my son
a job.
A job.
He needs to earn some pocket money. To buy us Ferraris.
So what are they going to do? Gave him a job in the middle of a war. That doesn't sound like a good thing to
say. It's not in the middle of a war.
It is.
Oh, yeah. Well,
After Earth. Oh, you meant in real life. I thought you meant, like, in the movie.
No.
I was going to say, like, going to his commanding officer. Can I give my son a job? Yeah, sure. Do you want him dead? Whoa.
But no.
That film's alright, I guess.
But I Am Legend, though, often referred to as one of the greatest films.
It's not the greatest. It's good, but it's not the greatest.
They have
two endings to it.
They have two endings?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know that?
I didn't know that. I remember I watched it once.
If you watch, the ending's kind of quite... kind of abrupt and weird.
What, the ultimate ending?
I don't remember. I watched it once and kind of forgot exactly what happens.
They filmed two endings. One was where it's, they're stuck in the basement, and then they, like, pray to God, and then God saves them.
What?
That's beautiful.
God saves them?
Yeah, and then Will Smith sacrifices himself.
Still.
And that was the ending
what?
They aired in America, and everyone really liked it. And
really?
There was another ending, yeah. And there was another ending where, the head zombie guy that was chasing them?
Yeah. Sure, go on.
Yeah, well, there's like a leader of the pack of, like, zombie things which is chasing them, and it turns out that it's after, like, this little girl who's with Will Smith that has, like, a tattoo on her, and he, like, paints, like, the same tattoo on the window in front of Will Smith of the little girl, and it's his daughter, and then he gives her the daughter, and they all go away.
No.
Because it turns out they're actually smart, and then they leave, and they find a cure.
Oh.
And then, but they filmed the other ending because it was better for, like, the American demographic.
Sure.
It's kind of weird.
I haven't seen it.
It's kind of weird.
There's not many films I've seen. For some reason, while you were saying that, I was just thinking of Cloverfield.
Cloverfield.
Yeah. They're both kind of set in New York, aren't they?
New York. Except they're, like, completely different.
Except completely different, yeah.
Cloverfield's good.
Cloverfield is the media studies film.
Unless you've got, like, a motion sickness.
It's the only film that I remember from media studies. That's all they showed us.
No, I remember, what was it? Final Destination, the first one.
Really?
Analysing one scene as to, like, the why the shot was good or something. I don't know, it's complete rubbish.
What was the last film you watched?
The last film I watched?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
Oh, we watched.
Yeah.
Last night we watched Jeepers Creepers 2.
That's hilarious.
Which it wasn't good.
I genuinely don't know the last film I saw.
Wow.
Oh no, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, that was it. I rewatched on DVD. Because I found a DVD in the charity shop for like a quid. I was like, unsold. Two disc, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Yep, help charity.
Yeah.
Well.
Helping him out. It was sealed as well. That was the
sealed,
most impressive
blimey.
Thing.
You could
Someone
have
really
that.
Wanted to get rid of that.
You could have bought it from, I don't know, bought, go to Tesco, buy it there, and then just come back with your sealed copy and be like, oh, can I get my money back, please?
I don't think that's how charity would work.
Wouldn't that just make the same amount?
Well, you'd have to steal a receipt off someone.
I just have two sealed copies.
No, you'd have to buy the one from the charity shop.
Yeah, buy the one from the charity shop.
Yep. You'd have to steal the receipt from someone.
Steal the receipt!
Who also bought that film from Tesco.
From Tesco's.
And then return the charity shop one.
And then, return the charity shop one to Tesco's?
Yeah.
Why wouldn't I return the one from Tesco's to Tesco's? Oh, no, sorry.
Can we get a little too far into this?
This is too complex.
Yeah.
Wait, I don't understand this. I have... okay, I go
Never
to,
mind.
I go into a charity
you don't
shop.
You dwell on it.
I go into a charity shop. I have £2.
Yep.
I spend that £2 on Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Yep.
So I now have nothing in my pocket.
Yes.
It's a sealed copy, a sealed DVD. That's
yep.
what I have now, a sealed DVD in my hands.
Uh-huh.
I then go to Tesco's,
mm-hmm.
wait until someone has a receipt.
Yep.
And then give them my copy of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
No. No, you're not following this.
That's not.
You take their receipt from their bought copy, and then you return it at full price. And you make profit.
Yeah, but then I don't have a copy of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, do I?
Yeah, but then you torrent it.
Back to Super.
Then you go back to the charity shop. Then you go back to the charity shop and buy even more.
And find it again.
And then you just linger around the DVD section of Tesco for waiting.
Just getting very suspicious every so often. It's like, I've got to find someone with a receipt.
You keep buying
just
like
stood at the entrance like, can I have a receipt?
You keep going and buying like boxes of Tic Tacs and really cheap items, just following someone.
Just what? Oh, you mean just buying Tic Tacs? I thought you meant like getting Tic Tacs and like throwing them at people or something.
Yeah, like, to distract
them. Shaking them on people as like confetti or something.
But no, the last film me and Tom watched was Jeepers Creepers and Jeepers Creepers 2.
Jeepers Creepers?
That's a bad film.
Jeepers Creepers?
A very bad film.
I did not like that film.
But it's so bad that it's good.
Something Peepers?
Yeah.
Where'd you get those Peepers?
Where'd you get those Peepers? Have you seen it?
I haven't.
It's about a big.
You're not missing out.
Big man slash. Bat slash
Batman,
dead guy,
zombie thing,
Batman,
and he kind of
giant mothball.
He kind of hibernates for like 23 years, and then he wakes up.
Oddly specific.
Yeah, it is quite specific. And then he wakes up and he goes around and he eats body parts from people, and he kind of replaces his body parts with them.
So Frankenstein,
pretty much, but on the go.
Yeah.
Frankenstein on the go.
But he can fly and it's not really explained. And it's very bad.
Because he ate a bunch of crows, probably.
Just grew some wings from it.
Yeah.
This
he ate too much
terrible.
KFC and then it's really bad. You should watch it.
Is that what happens if you eat lots of KFC? You suddenly grow
wings? You grow wings. You also grow a thick crust.
Of 11 herbs and spices.
Yeah.
But of course, the danger with that is you'd start eating yourself. So delicious.
You wake up with gravy next year.
And then you'd have to eat more. You'd have to eat more KFC to grow it back.
Which is a constant loop of KFC. Just eat the KFC, eat your skin, eat
more
KFC.
Or you can bat to your arm and then just
bat to
fry
your arm.
It. Fry it again.
That's not.
I don't think you would eat yourself though, even if you were
delicious. I don't think you would.
Should we talk about some superheroes?
Yeah, let's talk about superheroes. How many comics have you read then?
Oh god!
Any comics?
The Walking Dead.
Yeah.
Is that Walking a comic?
Dead. Yeah.
Oh yeah, they do. Yeah, they do.
It's originally a comic.
I don't read superhero comics. If I didn't read comics, why did I specify superheroes? I bought a copy of Joker number one because it had a cool holographic front thing.
But you didn't read it.
I did read it. It's pretty good. But I didn't want to carry on because every other page was an advert.
No, I've read the first few Walking Dead books. They're quite expensive, so I didn't get the rest of them. Not that interested. I'd prefer the TV series. But they're very good, still.
I'm not really interested in TV series.
You've got a big collection of manga. That's about it. Is that a comic?
Huh?
Is that class of the comic?
Well, if it's a book that has...
Yeah. I've always wanted to read a comic. It's called Chew.
Chew?
It sounds pretty nice.
Chew?
Chew. It's about, like, a private detective who's a cannibal.
What?
Yeah, he eats the crime scene and
he learns
where the killer was
on the taste,
so he can track them down.
Can you just imagine, like, there's loads of forensic people there, and then he's just sitting there eating the body, and they're like,
"Dave, what are you doing? Like,
picnic table."
Surely, I'm really not comfortable with this. Just let him do it.
Just let him carry on. He knows what he's doing.
And he's just like.
Yeah, how does he find a killer from that?
It's really weird.
I was thinking, like, is it a case of, like, genuine he can taste the, like, skin type or something? You taste salty. You work in the salt mine. it was your boss, Dave, from down the salt mine. Done.
What if he started working in, like, forensics? Like, where they do the, what are they called?
Autopsies?
What if he went to, like, doing the autopsies and stuff? They send him a body and they're like, I want the results from this in 3 hours, and then they come back and he's like literally just got a huge belly the size
he's
of a human.
Got a napkin in
and he's just like, oh, and like, hey Dave, how are the results going? Still processing them.
Tell him 20 minutes.
He gets one of those like slightly warm moist towelettes.
Wiping his hands.
He's got one of those like garlic butter dip things from Domino's as well.
Just dipping it in individual fingers.
That sounds quite an interesting comic.
Yeah. Yeah, I really want to read it now. Yeah. I really want
to
read
it. I have to link it to
him. Do it.
Yeah. What's everyone's favourite comic or comic book's hero?
You mean like originally from a comic?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't really read them.
Probably anything.
Couldn't say. I really couldn't say. I don't read them.
You know what I like, which segues into our next song, is the original Iron Man, who just looked like a massive, like, a Pepper Pot.
Why didn't they keep that design?
Oh, I wish they had. It.
They sort of did.
They tried to, didn't they? Yeah. Oh, we're going to have to find a picture of that while we play our next song. Our next song is from, I think it's from Iron Man. I looked online and found Iron Man by Black Sabbath. It's got Iron Man in it, so I was like, it's gonna be good play that. Let's play it. Iron Man, Black Sabbath.
That was Iron Man by Black Sabbath.
That was Iron Man.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Pretty damn good. Before we carry on, we have to mention Sonant Live on the 30th of January. 8 p.m. live. Watch on Facebook. You can watch things on Facebook. That's news to me. Facebook.com/SonantLive or YouTube.com/SonarMediaOnline. Yeah.
Nice.
Sonant Live.
Nice. What is it?
Yeah.
It's Sonant Live.
Oh. Okay. It's like Big Brother.
It's a deep philosophical question. What is Sonant Live?
It's only 8 p.m. onwards.
8 p.m. onwards, yeah.
What is it?
It could be a concert or something.
Or is that just when it launches and then it's non-stop live, non-stop?
No, it's every
always
week.
Always watched.
It's every week.
It's like a Truman Show for students.
Sonant Live.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what the SU does? They do flavoured drinks of superheroes.
They do.
They have flavours such as... We're trying to remember these off by heart.
They have Spyro.
Spyro, yep. The GTA 5 one, the Cheeky V. Human Torch. That's pretty good. It's very cinnamon.
They look much more... They look much more colourful on the posters.
That's the lighting.
Oh, yeah, that's just the lighting. That's just how good they look.
They should, like, dye
That's them. Ryan. Ryan Stanek. I hope I'm saying that right. His pro Photoshop work.
Nice.
Very, nice. Very good. If I had to have any Photoshop done, I would go and get him.
Cool.
Just saying. There's a Hulk as well, isn't there?
There's a
Hulk burger. That's what I'm thinking of, which is like three burgers and three bits of cheese.
Oh,
for £10. £10 though.
And there's the Thing Burger, which is
the Thing.
It's just
a rock.
It's kind of orange and crusty.
It's just a cinder block.
Didn't we talk about this on like our first show of burgers made of sand, or was that? Oh no, that was me on the Pokemon night. We were talking about they had the flavoured cocktails named after Pokemon, like Pikachu was the yellow one, stuff like that.
Oh yeah.
And I was saying, why don't they do a Sandshrew one with like real sand in and Baileys? Baileys and sand, that was it.
Ugh.
Yeah.
Ugh.
That was the response of everyone else there that evening.
You could put like Demerara sugar in it.
So. Yeah.
Yeah. I was just thinking, like, you know, Baileys, that's a classically kind of creamy...
Yeah, but Baileys creamy. In a cocktail.
Well,
Baileys.
For Sandshrew.
Baileys. Creamy.
It has that gritty aftertaste.
Mm.
It has to have some kind... Maybe popping candy or something.
Put some dirt in it.
Some literal dirt.
Just scrape, like, the floor or something, I don't know.
Refine some dirt.
We are not endorsing that the SU does this,
by the way. Yeah, we're not endorsing this at all. We think it'd be cool.
We think it'd be really cool if they just put dirt in, you know.
You just put dirt in, yeah.
Why not?
Don't even do it on request, just do it randomly.
Yeah, people you don't like.
People you don't like, random people. People you overhear talking about things you don't understand or don't like.
People you don't like, but specifically like Pokemon.
No, this was just ideas we were coming up on the night. We had another idea, which I've completely forgotten. Oh, it was a great idea as well. Oh, I'll try and remember it during our next song, which... I love this song. Has nothing to do with superheroes. But while I was looking around for songs to do with superheroes the other night, songs with superheroes in the lyrics, this was the first one that came up because it has the word Superman in. One of the lyrics. So I was like, I'm playing that. I don't care. I'm playing that. I think you can understand, though, because it's Billy Idol, White Wedding.
Part one.
Part one, not part two or three.
So it's PT1.
PT1.
Michael, what have you done?
Why is it a white wedding?
A white wedding?
Why not red or green or black or purple?
It represents the woman's purity to her husband or something, isn't it?
Yeah.
And if you wear black, it means you're a goth.
So why do the guys always wear black suits?
Because men are impure.
Men are goths.
And miserable.
I read earlier on about bridesmaids apparently were originally introduced in like pagan times. To confuse evil spirits into who the real bride was.
So they're basically meat shields.
Yeah. So there's like a one.
That's brilliant.
So there'd be a 1 in 3 chance of the bride becoming evil.
Yeah, it then of course raises the question of, well, these spirits aren't very smart then. Because, I mean, if you see one woman at an altar with another man, and two just random women, like, next to them, I think, you know, you can tell which one's getting married.
So doesn't that just mean that there's like a 1 in 3 chance that...
A 1 in 3 chance. One of the
women is going to be possessed and become evil.
Just get 3 spirits.
Yeah.
Why faff around with 1? That seems stupid.
Well, who knows? We're on to our...
Yep, we're coming into the final minutes. We're coming into our worst song. We couldn't... There wasn't really a worst song this week. There wasn't really a terrible one.
You didn't look hard enough.
No, we didn't.
You need to look in the deep layers of YouTube scum to find some...
Deep, I can think of many.
The deep web.
Get rid of the cream and just dig deep
just
down.
Dig into the barrel.
Bottom
dig
of the jar.
Deep down. I found this song, which I thought sounded a bit odd and thought that everyone would agree with me, but no one agrees with me, and even I don't agree with myself.
I've not heard it yet.
I liked it.
Well, Louis hasn't heard it yet, so he might think it's terrible, he might think it's good. We're going to let our special guest, Tom, introduce this one.
Alright, it is Opposites Attract by Paul Rudd.
Paul Rudd, what?
Paul Rudd.
Paul Abdul.
Oh, Paul Rudd.
Paul, by Rudd. Paul Rudd, Paul the Rudd. Famous
Paul
actor.
Paul Rudd, the actor.
Debut album.
Yeah, Paul Abdul, Opposites Attract. Tricourse out for another week.
Goodbye.
See you guys next week. Goodbye.